spring, there were so many people injured, it was almost like patchwork at times. But, you know, now everybody's out here. Guys are getting reps. It was great to see Trent out here. It was great to see David Mackle, Mario Rosen, you know, a lot of guys who didn't practice, Kyle Gale, you know, Irv Tetree. I mean, you know, again, I don't have a long enough time to interview with you to name all the guys who didn't practice. So it was exciting to see them. And they ran around, and you know, there's some folks here watching practice. So it's exciting. It's great to be back out on the field, and I can't wait for tomorrow. I wouldn't single out an individual only because I would be more comfortable doing that after I watched the tape and actually saw what they did. But, you know, the defensive line, I think we got a group of kids there, a core group of kids that you know, we can get them going the right direction and playing as hard as they'll possibly play every play. I think we can be pretty talented up front. Well, NCAA rules dictates almost everything now. So the first 2 days are helmets only and you know, virtually non-contact. Then you have a couple days where your helmets and shoulder pads and you know, you're able to do some more football specific stuff in terms of blocking and you know, moving some bodies around. And then the fifth day of practice will be you know, an opportunity to be in full pads, wear pants, and you know, in those days you can actually take people to the ground and tackle and you know, scrimmage, for the lack of a better word. So, you know, it'll be a little bit more physical there. And then, you know, ultimately for us, on our sixth day, we take off. You know, we have off 3 days during training camp, and that'll be one of our days, and give the kids an opportunity to, you know, what we call rest and recovery, and they'll have an opportunity to watch film and get a lift in and do some things without practicing. And, you know, then we'll get back at it the next day.